Introducing first, fighting out of the blue.
What's up, guys? James the Executioner Vic here. Gonna be uploading a lot more content to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to the channel. Feel free to ask any questions. I'll gladly get back and answer the questions and show the techniques. Thank you guys for the support. Appreciate it. What's up, guys? Going to show you a good technique today for MMA. Basically a ground and pound drill that we like to do. My coach, Master Lord Irvin, had showed me years ago, and we've drilled this a lot throughout camps and stuff, and I've gotten pretty good at it through thousands of reps and stuff. So this is a good ground and pound drill for the top person to land punches when this bottom person is trying to control your wrist, right? So here, we're here in full guard in an MMA scenario. Relax for a second. MMA scenario, he knows punches are coming. He knows that I'm gonna start punching, right? So I like to do this. A lot of people like to do this from the bottom. They like to grab the wrist. So that really does, especially if this person, maybe he has big hands or he just has a strong grip. It's hard to break this and just be able to posture down and land. He's gonna grab these. Maybe he would try to grab the head with the other one and control and pull me tight where there's no space where I can't land anything big, right? So what I'm gonna do here is very simple. I'm here, I'm still right here in jiu-jitsu position where I don't want him to be able to pull my head down, get posture. I'm keeping a good base. I'm going to lift this arm up a little bit. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this hand, I'm going to chop this, and as I do, I'm gonna pull this away. So I'm gonna push, pull. Push, pull. And when I do, I'm gonna grab this and I'm gonna pin it. So we're here holding a little tight. I'm here, I'm gonna go there, and then I'm gonna pin. And I'm gonna start hitting him with this free hand. He's naturally gonna bring this over. So if he doesn't bring that over, then it's only gonna take a few punches. He's gonna be out anyway, right? So he's gonna bring it over. When he brings it over, I'm gonna grab this one and I'm gonna pin this one to his waist. Then I'm gonna start punching. He's either going to turn and open his legs up. He's gotta do something to try to get out. He's in a really bad position here. If he doesn't, I'm just going to keep hitting him until I finish him, right? So he's probably going to turn this way and open his legs up. When he does, I like to put my hand on the mat here, and then I skip over, and I get over into half guard, right? And now from here, I like to do the head position and just work punches. So from the other side, so you can see it a little better, he's in full guard. He's controlling the wrist. I'm here. I'm up. Push, pull, right? Push, pull, pin. I'm hitting. I go here. He don't like that. I can throw elbows. I'm here. I like to base my hand, put my head down. I skip the hips over, and then I work from here. Now I can come through. I could come here. I like to come here, go doors. I could do many things from here. I could pass, get side control. I could try to slide the knee and go to full mount. I could do a lot of stuff if I have a well rounded game to do so. But I like to stay in half guard, in position in half guard, because half guard is a very dominant position in MMA where you can really control the person. You can hold them there for even a couple minutes at a time where they can't escape the half guard, and you can start just landing good shots and just winning the rounds on points by keeping someone in the half guard. When you advance the mount or you advance to side control, it gives them a bigger opportunity to escape. So play with that. Tell me what you guys think. Please subscribe to the channel. Follow us on social media. James Vic MMA, Sensei Adrian. Thank you, guys. Comment below any questions or techniques you'd like to see in the future. Thank you.